Before we get into your kind of your writing routine, you talk about the one thing that I saw, someone asked you advice, and you said, what's something that you would give a new, tell a new comic, and you go, stage time. And you are a comedian in Philadelphia, where, even though we're the fifth biggest city in the country, we have maybe one mic/show, venue a night kind of thing, maybe two kind of thing. So, mm-hmm. It's not New York City where you can get up seven or eight times in a night. So, if your advice is stage time, how do you then kind of curtail that into being a Philadelphia comedian, getting that stage time when there's a lack of supply and a huge demand for it?
Okay, well, I don't know what the open mics are now, mm-hmm. but for 2 or 3 years there in comedy, I was getting on stage about anywhere from 7 to 12 times a week. I could get on stage twice on Mondays, twice on Tuesdays, four times most Wednesdays, once or twice on Thursdays, and then I would either do guest sets or host at a comedy club Friday or Saturday, mm-hmm. and it was a late night Sunday mic. So for a while there, for years, from like 2006 to like maybe 2008, I mean, I was going out six nights a week and sometimes twice a night. Didn't always work out that way, but mm-hmm. there were open mics every night of the week, and Wednesdays I could do four. I did four a bunch of times. I'd go to Abilene, 4th and South.
Okay.
Go on before the opening band, run to the Laugh House two blocks down, do their open mic, drive to the Comedy Cabaret in the Northeast, get on stage for the third time, and then come back to Abilene again and perform before or after the last band in front of a completely different crowd because a new crowd was there 5 hours later.
Okay,
so
wow.
That was like one or two Wednesdays a month. I would get on stage four times every Wednesday. And Helium had an open mic on Tuesdays. There was another open mic called Sour Grapes on Tuesdays. Uh-huh. Mondays was Bar Noir. And Keith from up the block had a late night open mic on Mondays. And then the Laugh House had a showcase. And there was an open mic at a bar called Reef around the corner. And then Fridays, I could do the Comedy Cabaret in Runnymede, New Jersey, or Rascals in Cherry Hill. There was a place called Chuckles out in the suburbs. So there was a lot of stage time then.
Yeah.
I don't know what it's like now, but I mean, I was hitting the pavement pretty hard for a couple years there.
Yeah,
this was every single night for years.
That's incredible work ethic. And I mean, I guess it shows. I mean, you've risen to the top. So I would say,
I have nothing else to do. So.
and you're constantly, you're doing shows in front of like drunk people and comedians and maybe nobody. Like, what is it that you would learn in a situation where it's like, I really want to work out this bit, but there's nobody here willing to listen to it? What are some things that if a comic's like, hey, I'd rather just hang out at Helium's, work that angle for a while, get my in there, what would be your angle? Be like, no, there's some value in going to a bar on a Thursday night during baseball season and doing 5 minutes of jokes. What would you say the value in that is?
To get the words out for you. It took me a couple of years to realize that, obviously, as a comedian, you want to make the crowd laugh. I mean, duh. It's first and foremost. Mm-hmm. But at the same time, getting the words out for you is also a win. Like, let's say you have gigs over the weekend, mm-hmm. and you know they're going to be good crowds. It's a fun place. You like working. They get good clientele. Mm-hmm. But you want to work on something brand new, but the only other options are two shitty mics. So I would go to them just to get the words out so I can get my flow and groove. And then on the weekend, they might come out better than I thought because I already practiced them live.
Okay.
But now, granted, there are shitty drunk crowds that don't pay attention, and you might have to fight off distractions to where you can't get your groove down. Mm-hmm. But sometimes if the crowd isn't really fully paying attention, but you're kind of in your own zone and the words are coming out the way you want, that's still a win in
my
mind.
Okay.
I mean, you always want to make the crowd laugh, but I mean, there are certain nights where that's not even the goal in a way.
Okay.
If it's just, like a really, really rough crowd or really rough room.
Cool.